Hey guys, how you doing? This is JP Saricolia coming to you once again with another episode of Age of Heroes, my podcast. And first I want to say thank you for your support. And also just let you know, we didn't have a podcast on Monday. I'm changing the podcast schedule just to accommodate to my schedule, my personal schedule. And so I'm able to produce better content also in YouTube and here at the podcast. And really give you my best. So now we were doing 3 days a week. Now it's going to be 2 days a week. It's going to be Tuesdays and it's going to be Thursdays. So that means that I'm able to come here and talk about the newer things, the new subjects as soon as possible, and it really expand and get more information so we can talk about certain things and really go in depth. And also want to grow this. Also, the podcast has been growing, which I'm very glad. Now we have a new platform. Now we're in an iHeartRadio, which I was looking forward to do that. There's other platform that I'm still applying for them to have access to. So now you have a real list. You know, you can hear this podcast in iTunes, Stitcher. You can hear it on Spreaker. You can hear it on CastBox. You can hear it in TuneIn. So that means that you can get it in any Amazon device. You can hear it on Spotify. And, of course, iHeartRadio. Also, you can do it on SoundCloud, but SoundCloud is a bit iffy or a bit tricky in the way it does it. So, but you know, we're expanding to the bigger platforms, and I'm very glad. I'm very happy for that. You know, get to you so you can have access to it in any way possible, and you can listen to the podcast. You can download the podcast. You can listen it to your own convenience, and you can take it with you. That's the most important aspect. So I'm very glad that we're growing with the podcast. But today I want to talk about something that is very, I would say, important. And it's something that has been, I've been thinking about it since, you know, we've been for weeks, for months, we've been on this discussion, but I haven't really got to the chance to do it. Or first of all, I was a bit skeptical talking about it because this is a little bit political. And I don't like to get too much into political aspects, or, you know, although I have talked about political issues, I'm more like in the political, in the social political aspects of things, but never directly to really talk about the politics. But I think it's important because this affects us on this policies that are being applied, or they're the in this case, the U.S. government is trying to apply towards, you know, the, you know, goods, particularly coming from China with the tariffs. It really affects us all as collectors. And as people that love the industry, whether it's gaming, whether it's toy collecting, whether it's statues, action figures, you name it, everything that I collect, everything from diecast, all of the stuff that I love and I love dearly, technology, all of that comes from one way or another is produced, manufactured in China. 96% of, in this case of consoles are manufactured in China. So that's the reason why it is a big concern, because tariffs means that the cost is going to rise up. So I want to discuss it today. I want to be straight on this. We are not here to attack the president of the United States, Donald Trump. I might not agree with him in many, many aspects. You know, I respect him as a person, although I don't agree with him. I didn't vote for him, but you know, and but definitely we have to respect him. We're not going to attack him personally for his own beliefs. We're going to simply to state the facts and what my opinion in regards to it, and what we can do, because that's the pretty much the takeaway that I want to give. What we can do as collectors, as you know, fans of these hobbies that we partake. How can we react, or how can we act, and what can we do in order to benefit ourselves, of course. So, you know, and this is what I want to talk about today. Now, you know, there are a lot of sites talking about it. I'm going to have some links in the description below, so you can go to those sites, and they're talking about all this, the situations that are happening, you know, and, you know, how it's going to affect, you know, financially the country. So there's a lot of speculation right now, of course. There's a lot of speculation because, you know, there's a lot of unknowns how this is going to affect us. We know that Donald Trump is trying, President Trump is trying, and his administration is trying to protect, I would say, the properties of the U.S. You know, there's a lot of situations in China where a lot of things are manufactured in China, but there's a lot of knockoffs also in China. There's a lot of, it's a big knockoff industry. There's a strong, iffy industry in China where a lot of the products are manufactured in America. Well, are manufactured for American markets. Also, you know, you get knockoffs and you get this cheap handbags and all that kind of stuff. So there is a there is a big issue in China in regards to it, and that needs to be controlled. Now, the problem with the tariffs is that because we have moved this country, you know, as a nation, and many Western nations, we have moved from being manufacturers to be pretty much exporters. We have moved to be importers. We bring everything, manufactured things elsewhere, and then we bring them to the U.S. because it's cheaper. It's cheaper to manufacture outside of the U.S. and then bring these products to the U.S. For consumption. We are more into the service market. You know, we provide services. You know, the companies are based in the U.S. You know, Sony, Microsoft are based in the U.S. Companies are in Japan, like Nintendo. There are their company are based there. Japan has a lot of the biggest, you know, I would say companies in the world when it comes about technology, but all their products are manufactured, not in Japan. They're manufactured in China and other parts of the world. So all of this really affects, you know, the way we consume these products, of course, because they've been cheaper. You know, we love the cheap products. And that's something that happens here in America. We love cheap products. That's the reason why Walmart is such a big company, because we love things for lower prices. We love lower prices, you know, and, you know, products. And now with the problem with this trade wars that we are part of is that it really, there is an unknown aspect of it, how the future is going to unfold when the vast majority of the products we consume are manufactured in, you know, in China. For example, this, I have this where I'm watching on YouTube, this game probably was printed in Mexico. A lot of these games are printed in Mexico, but a lot of the technology from this, you know, on this, you know, it's manufactured, of course, in China. A lot of this technology is manufactured in places where, like this one too, they're manufactured in China in one way or another. Maybe they printed in Mexico and other parts of the world. And also, as we know, they've been trying to do some stuff with Mexico. You know, they want to do some tariffs as well. So all of this is consumed, is produced somewhere else, and then it's brought to the U.S. to be consumed. So now this is the thing, you know. It's not, doesn't mean that just because the tariffs are going, it means that they are losing money. No, because the price is going to go up. Because always the cost of a product is always passed to the consumer. Always. Everything you purchase. When you go to the store, if you love avocados, for example, avocados are expensive here in the U.S. in comparison if you go to Latin America. I can go to Mexico and buy avocados, you know, for piles and piles of avocados. They're cheaper. But there is cost involved into bringing them to the U.S. You know, in bringing them to the U.S., importing them to the U.S., it costs money. All of that is added to the bill that you have to pay. So you're not paying only for the avocado. You're paying for the cost of importing. And if you add tariffs to it, you're going to pay for those tariffs as well. So that means that it's going to be an increase of that 25% that they're going to tariff is going to be added eventually to the cost of the avocado. So if you, let's say I'm going to use a big bogus example. If you pay $1 for an avocado, for one single small little avocado, just an example. Now you're going to pay $125. The same applies to technology. You're paying $300 for a PS4, an Xbox. Now that 25% is going to be added that you're going to pay $375 at some point. So that's up, you know. And the problem is that that affects everything in America, because not only the products are manufactured, because many products are manufactured here in the U.S., but they're manufactured where parts that have been manufacture somewhere else, like the cars, the auto industry. As we know, the auto industry, cars are manufactured, many of them assembled here in the U.S., but many of those parts have been manufactured somewhere else, in Mexico, for example, or in other parts of the world. They're brought to the U.S. and they're assembled together. So all of that, it means that the cost goes to that, it's added to the final cost. So if a car costs you, you know, a certain amount of money, $20,000, $30,000, $50,000, you know, add 25% to that at some point. And it's a domino effect. It affects every single thing, everything we do. The more things cost, the more expensive things are, the more, and that goes for everything. Not necessarily that things are only fully manufactured in China. Everything that is manufactured also in the U.S. that comes with parts that come from some part of China. Sometimes those products are manufactured in other countries, but they have their supplies. You know, let's say something comes from Malaysia, you can go to Thailand, but some of their the material they use, the material they use to produce some of those parts are manufactured in China, or they're extracted in China, you know, because they have rich mineral resources. So everything is manufactured there. Well, some of those products are sent out and they're manufactured somewhere else, and they come here and they're assembled here. So there is a big thing. You know, we can go in detail time and time. We can be here hours and talking about how the whole process works. It is a very, it's a very big process, but everything comes to us. And as you know, as a collector, I've been a collector for many years of a lot of things, from diecast models, statues, action figures, toys, games, all of that. At some point, some parts of it have been manufactured in China. So it is safe to say that the cost is going to go up in all those products. And we have seen that increase over time. For example, with statues. Statues, we have seen that increase in pretty much in recent years. It's been a while since we have seen this constant growth in the manufacturing process. In this case, now I remember back in, I would say around 10 years ago, when you were able to get a statue for $250, $300. You know, a statue, a 1/4 scale, premium format sideshow, it was around that price. That was and it was a hefty price back then. Now, they don't go down from $1,000, $800, $900, $1,200 for a statue. And some of these products now, they come with a lot of, you know, cheap parts, like, you know, plastic, very cheap plastic, you know, parts. You know, before you get a massive thing, you know, very, the mass was really heavy, it was hefty. Now you get more stuff. Yeah, you can say that there's more detail on this stuff, but you're paying a lot of money. Now, if you add tariffs to that now, new tariffs, it's going to be almost impossible to purchase that for a decent price. Now, when you are a collector, you have to consider the value of things. You know, yes, we don't really talk about this a lot, you know, because sometimes there's this two schools of thought when it comes about collectibles. I'm talking about statues and also action figures. When a lot of people are like, they like to collect, but they want to retain value of their items because, you know, in the future, something happens, they can resell and they can regain at least some money or make some money back, and they can continue on collecting. That's part of the, that's, I think it's part of the allure of being a collector as well. The trading, you know, the selling, the buying and trading, the constant doing of that is really keeps people pretty much in the hobby. Now, and this other school of thought, people, they buy this more as, you know, gathering as much as they can. They see it from their, you know, this aesthetic point of view. They don't care about the value because they're not planning to sell. But ultimately, there's always going to be a point where you might have to sell. And if you have to sell, even you're not the type of person that like the trading part, when you come to sell, you want to at least have some value. The problem is that we have pretty much cap the price point, because there is, of course, first of all, there is a big influx of products. You know, in this case, the market is flooded with products, so it's hard to sell the product now because you have new stuff coming in. And if you pay top dollar for these products, you know, and that adds, you know, everything that has to do with the price, the cost of it, you know, the important cost, all of that, and tariffs, all of that added, you're paying top dollar for something that is you're never going to see the money back one way or another. You're going to lose a lot of money in the process. So that takes away the allure for a lot of people to be part of this hobby. And that's why you see a lot of collectors moving from this hobbies to other things, because they get jaded with it, because they're not making any money. Not only because they're here to make money, they are not surviving. The hobby is not thriving. They're losing money. Nobody wants to invest in something that you're not getting anything in return. That's just bottom line. And the same happens with the gamings. You know, those are love retro gaming. You know, as you know, as time progresses, you know, the cost of a lot of this old consoles go up because there's less and less and less. So, of course, there also is a given and applying and opening a room for a lot of these new consoles that are able to play, you know, old console games. You know, they can play things like the Retro 5, Retron 5, and all those things, the new Poly Mega that is coming, things that, you know, and there's some many new I would say clone consoles nowadays that is good, but a lot of them, almost all of them are manufactured in China as well. So that means that if they already capping the price, they're going to go up. So this is a big thing that it affects everything we do. It affects everything we do. Now, I'm not here to tell you, you know, we need to go against the president of the United States or we need to go against the government because, you know, there's ways to do it, of course, and that's why we have to support our candidates and we have to support and we have to vote the right way and vote for those that stand for what we believe. And that's how we express our vote. And, you know, we have to, you know, to be concerned about certain things. But there are things that we need to do in a practical way as collectors. Now, it means that just because the prices are going up, and it's very likely they're going to go up whether there are tariffs or not, that we have to be pretty smart in the way that we consume our products. This is the takeaway here. We need to be very smart in the way we consume these products. We need to be careful how we spend our money. Just because it looks, you know, like gold doesn't mean that it's gold in the end. So we have to be very smart. You know, it was a time where you were able to pretty much throw money at it, you know, all the time. I went through those times where I was able to throw money at everything I wanted and I lost a lot of money in the process. But I didn't care because I have the means. But now that is, I'm more careful of what I do because not only because I'm more mature, because probably my budget is not as it used to be, most importantly, but second, because I'm learning that not everything shines, everything that shines is gold. So we have to be very careful. So when you're buying something, be careful what you're purchasing. You have to be smart in the way you purchase. Don't pre-order everything just because it's out there, just because it looks nice on the promo pictures. You have to wait. And sometimes it's better just to wait till the final product is out so then we can make a decision if we want to buy it or not. Not just to jump on it just because of, you know, with everyone else, because everybody say, oh, this is the coolest thing, and we get so hyped with it that we miss the opportunity to really analyze the situation and then decide if this is for us or not. Because you're going to find so many people that are so discontent with the final product, or people that are so happy with the final product. And that applies for statues, that applies for diecast models, that applies for action figures, for toys, that applies for video games, that applies for anything. You know, people are so discontent with the final product. It's better just to wait when something is out and realize. With statues, the best way to do it is just wait till the stuff comes out. Then you say, well, this is good. People saying this is great. Then I can invest the money. Then it's worth that amount. Because I see people buying products that they pay top dollar for it, and it's just garbage when it comes out. You know, it has all the defects of the world. It's not even what it was promised. It was changed, totally changed, but you still pay a lot of money for it. And now trying to get rid of it is going to be a pain in the butt. You know, you are literally lost that money. If you pay $200 for something, not including the shipping, and it's in not good condition and it's not good, you're going to end up paying, you're pretty much just $200 to say goodbye to them because you're not going to get them back. You're not going to make your money back. The same happens with the consoles, with the Retron 5, whatever, with the new thing. You, once you get it, and if it's not what it is, just wait for the moment. A lot of people are skeptical about Poly Mega. You know, we're talking about gaming now. Wait for the last minute. Wait until it comes out. Then you make the decision. Right now, it seems good and cool and dandy. Don't just go and pre-order for $650 for the whole package. You know, you waste your money. If that thing doesn't come out the right way, then you're going to have a problem. That applies for everything. Toys, action figures, any products, the new, you know, televisions, the new technology, the new HDRs, all of that. You had to wait until you know for sure that whatever you're investing is going to last and is going to be something that you are invested on and that your money is going to the right place. Whether you make money or not out of that, but at least you are going to take the full benefit out of it. This is what you need to do. Yes, you know, whatever happens, you know, it's hard to determine exactly what's going to happen. All these trade wars are affecting, not only affect the companies, they affect the consumers. But just because it affects us doesn't mean that we have to be stupid about it. We need to be smart in our decision making. We need to be smart in what we're going to purchase. We need to be smart in everything we do. And once we make those decisions and we make clear those boundaries in our lives and the way we spend our money, then we can see the benefits out of, on the long run, long term. It is the way it is, you know. And I can tell you one thing. When we, and I'm going to use our example, when Tony and I, we decide to manufacture the Sabretooth statue, which we loved it, we wanted to make the prototype done. We went to different places, you know, here in the U.S., trying to see if we couldn't just get it done here in the U.S. And it was, you know, the price was really high. And a lot of experts, people that work in the industry told us, you know, you need to go to these companies. You need to do it in China. It's going to be cheaper and it's going to be better than anything else that can be produced in the U.S. And voila, it happened. You know, we did it and it was cheaper to do the whole thing, just to produce just the prototype that we wanted. And it was easy. And I can tell you one thing, and the same happens here. It's going to cost a lot of money. If the tax goes into effect, it's going to cost and affect the industry. It's not going to benefit the American industry. It's not going to benefit the American industry, the American companies. It's going to create effect because a lot of these companies are so behind in regards to the technology and into the application of the technology as they have in China by now. They do have a very concise system that they have applied for many years because they have become manufacturing a country. You know, they've been a manufacturing country for years. And so it's going to take a little bit of time for this, if that ever goes into effect, for the economy to rise up and for the manufacturing companies to produce at same level as China does, and if that ever happens. So in the meantime, as consumers, we have to be very smart in the way we're consuming products and how we spend our money. Not to throw the money just like that, just to spend it where it needs to go. And then, of course, we're going to see the effect, the benefit out of it. And we're not going to get tired and we're not going to get just jaded or burn out because, you know, things are not going our way. But what is your opinion? What do you think about these tariffs? Are you a fan of them? Are you supportive of Donald Trump, in this case, President Donald Trump? You think he's doing the right thing or do you think he's doing the wrong thing? I would like to hear your opinion in the comments below. So once again, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening to the podcast. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you're watching on YouTube and to follow me on social media. All the links are down below. So once again, God bless, my friends. Take care. And I'll talk to you again. Bye-bye.